Crow, what are you doing?
I'm checking to see where that son of a bitch is at. I know he's hiding around here somewhere.
Look, Crow, I highly doubt he's in here.
Look, I know he's probably not in here, but I gotta check. Ugh. Well, I guess he's not in here. So, door's locked, check the closet. Let's go ahead and have ourselves a roll battle.
Oh no.
Then it's agreed. Meta fighters ready? Roll battle!
Son of a bitch.
And this video is sponsored by NewTypeHQ.com. If you want to pick up yourself some tools, supplies, paints, or even Kotobukiya kits, you can go to their website and do /Krosama, so that way you can get 10% off your first purchase. So, on to the review. So after building this kit, I am honestly a mixed bag of emotions. It really does look great. I love the aesthetics, I love the design, but there are some faults in this kit. Okay, so let's talk design first. The head's gonna have that typical beetle look right there at the top, and then the face is going to be a little bit weird. It has a full screen, and it's just more or less like a television set. But I do like the two little clear red spots right there on the top. It kind of looks like a beetle's eyes. So this metabot is actually heavily influenced by the samurai, and probably the ones that are from the Kurosawa films. The hand in the chest, or little handprint, that's like the samurai resting their hand right inside there. Whereas in that other side, while it's so big, it's just basically the yukata or kimono just flapping in the wind. It's really cool, and I just love the aesthetics, especially just that handprint right there on the front. And on his right arm, he's going to have a bladed weapon, which is really cool because he's obviously not going to hold it. It's just going to kind of look like it's coming from the sleeve of his kimono. So I do like the aesthetics of this, and it can be packed away right there at the back. On this arm is basically going to be a hammer weapon. And down here is going to look a lot like the kimono pants as well as the sandals. Just looks really good and truly, truly love the design. And this Metabot is actually going to be an electric type user in the DS game. That's a pretty cool attribute. Honestly, I don't really see too many Metabots rocking an electric type base attack, so seeing this is really welcoming. Now looking at surface detail, this kit's not really going to have it. You can obviously detail up the chest, or if you want, the little pants, do some panel lining around that, but for the most part, this kit is very bland when it comes to surface details. Now for seam lines, there's going to be quite a few. One of them is going to be right here on top of the head, but that is pretty necessary because you need to take off this front faceplate so that way you can interchange these little, clear red plates. But if you want to keep it as is because you painted it, then you're going to have to seam line removal that. Then you're going to have one right here alongside these ears, along the top of the shoulders, front part of the arm, all the hands, sword weapon, chest, legs, and his hammer weapon. And this Metabot is going to have an open hatch gimmick, so that way you can see the metal right inside. But the problem with this is it's very loose, and I don't understand why, because the gun nose had no issue keeping this closed. Now if you want to take off the faceplate and interchange it, what you're going to find is by far the scariest face I've ever seen on a Metabot. But for the faceplate, you are going to have this kind of just glancing looking one. This other glancing one, which doesn't look that different. This more sinister, piercing looking one. And my favorite, the cracked faceplate. Honestly, I wish this one had the eyes, because seeing it like pretty much all circular is a little bit weird, but I do love that crack right there. Now for hands, he is gonna have two fists, two grabby hands, and two straight finger hands. Now for the waist, this is pretty much going to be like one circular part, and you basically peg it right in, but you can actually take this out and interchange it. And once you have it plugged in, that just means like this little peg right here isn't really going to move around within the polycap, and it's really weak. It doesn't really do much. It just kind of sits there, and it looks pretty horrible. But you do get a second one, which is a little bit bigger, so let's try this one out. So believe it or not, this piece is actually too big for the waist. It's just too round and circular for it to actually peg in. And I looked through the manual, but didn't see anything about it. It actually kind of shows nothing really about this particular one, but the small one instead. Now, something to note is that you are going to have these extra poly caps, which are going to be necessary because the ones I use for the elbow are just completely getting torn up and broken because this is really, really bad of a connection and just essentially strips this. So I'm going to replace it once I paint the kit. And you also get the Metabot's metal as well as the stand, so that way we can plug up some little action dialogue. So we have this one that says pretty much along the lines of "you're too weak." This one that says, This one's like, "if you have a problem, then come," something along those lines. This one says, "superb view." And this one says something like, "oh, is this seriously it?" Something like that. You also get one of the cut up Metabots and a free dialogue box for you to write whatever you want. Now, before I cover the weapons, let me just roll into the articulation. So prepare for this. Head is going to be on a polycap ball joint. Ears, ball jointed polycaps. This part can move forward and back, pretty much left and right. Shoulders is basically dual polycaps inside here, so it's a decent range of movement, but it's only going to go up about that far out. Rotation at the bicep. These elbows are by far the most trash of any elbow I've ever seen in my entire life. I would accept a basic Genoese 90 degree bend over this. It is essentially a polycap. Whoop, that's not supposed to happen. It's essentially a polycap that just rests inside there. So granted, you can bend it in different ways, but it is really, really bad and just tends to pop off. And of course, you've seen right here, you do have a polycap ball joint for the forearm, so this can actually rotate. Now this whole hammer part can actually move back and forth, but you're gonna have to take out the hand first. And when you do that, you can rotate the hammer back, plug in the hand, and bam, you can actually have them do some hand poses without the hammer being deployed. Hands are also going to be on a ball joint polycap. You've already seen the waist, but it's basically going to be two polycaps inside here and can make it rotate quite a bit. So this is actually really nice of an ab crunch. Now these hips are pretty much really bad. They are just polycap, you know, joints, and they're not going to do much except for fall off. Rotation right here for the top of the hip. You get a halfway decent knee bend, but this is always going to be cracking, so prepare to do some gluing. Ball joint for the ankles, and another peg and polycap for the foot, which actually gives it a pretty good toe bend. Now you do get this secondary hip joint, so that way it can actually bring the leg a little bit closer inwards. That's pretty much for setting up different poses. Now, if you pretty much want this sword to kind of go back inside this, I guess you want to call it a sheath, then you're going to have to do some part swapping. Let's take this back part off. We're going to plug in this larger one, unplug the sword, and plug in this yellow part. And now you basically have that part inside the sheath. Now for stands, you are going to have one included that basically fits for any like Figma stand or even Bandai stand, and it plugs right underneath the Metabot like so. So the last accessory this kit's going to come with is going to be this shield arm. It's okay. I like the little emblem, the little unicorn emblem on the front. If you definitely want to, you can do some reverse washing to make that whiter, you know, whatever default colors you really want to. It's a nice enough arm. I don't mind it, but I'm not big on the defensive side of Metabots. I really like the offensive ones, especially like some of the support kind. I don't really care for any thick defense oriented Metabots. So I'm still on the fence if I'm going to paint this arm or not, but it is nice enough to, you know, it's a welcoming addition to this particular kit. And I don't think any other Metabots comes with a sub arm or any other like limbs. So it's really cool, but it's probably just going to be a pass for me. And get put right into the box. Now, like you've seen earlier, I'm actually going to be using the Aurora Effect Yellow from the Figurize Standard line for this kit. It's a really nice addition. It came out in 2016, found it for about like $8 or $7. So if you can find it, this is actually a really good kit for the Metabot kit because of the fact that it's an electric base user, so it kind of just matches the overall theme. Alright guys, so on to my final thoughts. Honestly, I'm just going to go with the pros because there's a lot more cons than what there are pros. For pros, I personally think the design is splendid. I love this design. It's honestly reaching towards my favorite Metabot design to date. And I know a lot of people think that's crazy because what about Metabee? What about Scissorhead? What about Arc Beetle, Titan Beetle? You know, I love those as well, but this one, it just has that samurai effect. It has the thunder ability. It's really cool. I love it. I absolutely love it. So, what else is pros? It comes with a good amount of accessories. That's actually a pretty good, you know, plus. I do love some of the visor effects. I think those are really cool, especially the cracked visor one. That's pretty much where it stops, honestly, guys. For the cons, let me tell you guys, the articulation is really bad. Like, I'm not even talking about articulation in terms of the points of articulation, like the bends, the degrees of it. I'm talking about the actual points where the friction, you know, meets plastic and polycap. Pretty much the elbows, the hips, the waist, those are horrendous. They just constantly pop off. The arm, elbow, just pops off every chance it gets. It's really hard to handle without proper like tools like glue or, you know, some kind of cement. You're gonna have to do some work on this kit to make it really pop. I think even at its base level, it's okay. It looks fine just as a straight build without any extra paint or, you know, panel lines or anything. But this kit needs to be dealt with. It needs paint. It needs like glue. It needs some kind of like better friction with these joints because the polycaps are just so bad. And what's funny is I did have someone on Reddit, you know, say that theirs is great. I don't know where they are with like in terms of like how many Bandai kits they build in conjunction with Hasegawa or Kotobukiya. But out of everything I've built in the terms of like Plamo, this is one of the worst kits I've ever built. I just did not really enjoy it. I actually took a day break because after just building the arms first, I was fed up. It was honestly a headache, a nightmare. But I think overall the kit's going to look great once I finish painting it. I think I can really bring out a little bit of the aesthetic. I just really need to find a particular decal that I would like to put on the shoulder, but I'm having a little bit of a trouble finding that decal, so I'm gonna try this weekend. If I can't find it Saturday, then it just is what it is. Otherwise, it's a kit that if you're gonna purchase it, even, you know, watching this review, you probably just love you know, Sanjuuro. You just really love the aesthetics and design, which is completely fine and understandable. But if you have no really affinity for this mobile suit. If you have no affinity for this Metabot, I would honestly just say pass on it, please. If you want to support Metabots, then pick it up. But if you're really just not adamant on supporting Metabots or supporting, you know, this franchise in general, just pass on it. You're not gonna have a great time, and I don't want anyone, you know, feeling that burden of like, oh my god, I paid this much money for this kit, because chances are you're not finding this kit for its retail price, which is like $30. You're probably gonna find it for like $45 or more. But, you know, other than that, guys, you know, I really didn't want to be a Debbie Downer. It's a really cool looking Metabot. It's pretty much my favorite Metabot at this point. But yeah, the build and the overall handling is extremely subpar. So I'm just going to leave it at that, guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. And like always, if you can, definitely leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll be seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.